Hi, this is Jane, and today I will be discussing a real estate statistic called absorption rate. Just to outline what we'll be doing for this session, I'm going to show you the formula for absorption rate. We'll use actual data from MLS and actually calculate the absorption rate for several cities in the Bay Area. And lastly, I will show you how the calculation can be put in Excel, and I've created an Excel worksheet for that. Okay, so what is absorption rate? Simply put, it is the rate at which current available listings on the market are converted to sales given historical data. It is expressed in terms of number of months. So for example, an absorption rate of 2 months means that there is 2 months worth of housing supply on the market. Said in another way, this figure means that the current inventory is expected to run out in 2 months. So absorption rate is used as an indicator of how tight the housing supply is, whether it's a buyer's market or seller's market. So the formula of absorption rate is very simple. There are two measures that are needed to calculate absorption rate. The first is the number of active and pending listings on the market. In short, this is the number of unsold listings for a given market, and this is divided by the second measure, which is the average number of homes sold per month. It's that simple. Let's use an actual example to illustrate absorption rate, and let's do an actual calculation. So I have here some data that I've run on MLS. This is an actual snapshot of MLS listings of single detached family homes that are for sale in Fremont, California. In other words, this is the number of active and pending listings. So we see that this number here, 259, is the number of listings that are available on the market. Let's remember this number. Now let's go to historical data. And here are homes that were sold in Fremont, and I ran the data for the last 6 months. So this number here, 533, represents the number of homes sold within the last 6 months. Now what we need is the average. So what we need to do is divide 533 by 6 to get the average sales per month. And we have the result, which is 88.83. This will serve as our divisor in our calculation. Next, we are ready to calculate the absorption rate in Fremont. So let's go back to our formula here. So the number of active and pending listings, we have that number, which is 259, and this is divided by the average number of homes sold per month, and we have that as 88.83. And the result is 2.92. This is our absorption rate. So we can say that the housing supply of detached family homes in Fremont is tight, with the current inventory expected to run out in 2.92 months. Now let's transcribe these calculations into Excel. So I've created a worksheet here that takes care of calculating the absorption rate as long as we input the necessary data. So if we apply our Fremont data, what's needed here is the number of homes for sale, which is the number of active and pending listings in Fremont, which is 259 is the number we had earlier. Let's put that there. Next is the number of homes sold, and we have the number 533 from our previous run, which is in the last 6 months. Okay, and we can see that on the next line, which is average number of homes sold per month, is that it has been calculated for us, which is 88.83. And the next line is the absorption rate, which is 2.92, which was calculated by dividing 259 by 88.83. You can see that this matches our figure earlier. And if we click on the next tab, which is chart, I've created a bar chart to show the calculated absorption rate in Fremont, which is 2.92. Okay, so let me just show you one more example, and this time we'll use the housing data for the city of Hayward. So in Hayward, the number of homes for sale as of May 6, 2015 is 257, and the number of homes sold within the last 6 months is 418. So we have those two numbers, and so let's go back to our worksheet and input these numbers. So for Hayward, the number of homes for sale is 257, so let's put that there. And the number of homes sold is 418. And the months stay at 6 months, and we see the average calculated is 69.67, and the absorption rate is 3.69. And let's see the chart here. So that has adjusted to 3.69, and there you go. That is the absorption rate in real estate terms.